sabi ni ako.
Ayoko nang mag-isip. Ayoko nang mag-isip.
Alam niyo, hindi ko alam kung ba't ganito ako magsalita ngayon.
Ulit ulit sinasabi ko.
Hey everyone, this is Kat and welcome back to the bookish side of me. You know what? I am not planning to do any video for the week because I have two live shows on the weekend. The first one is going to be my book haul for my first anniversary on BookTube and also my 1,000 subscribers Thanksgiving. It's gonna be on Saturday. The link is gonna be on the description box. And then on Sunday, I'm going to do a live book discussion for the three hosts at Trisha Papers channel. The link is also gonna be on the description box. But then, Gerald of Gerald the Bookworm posted the PHILMYTH Readathon for this year. He posted his announcement video a few hours ago and it's gonna be on the description box as well. And I just want to post my TBR, so that's why I'm filming this right now. So first, before we go to the details of the readathon and the reason why I wanted to join again for this year, make sure that you are already subscribed, like this video, and comment down below if you're going to participate as well. And also for the whole video, I'm gonna speak in Tagalog because the prompts are in Tagalog and I just want to speak freely. So yeah, let's do this video. Alright, so PHILMYTH Readathon. Kung hindi nyo pa alam guys, ito yung unang readathon na sinalihan ko noong 2020 when I got back from a reading slump for like 2 years. So it really opened a lot of opportunities for me. I met a lot of people from the participants of the readathon last year and sila yung mga friends ko ngayon. Sila yung support system ko dito sa book community. And I keep on saying this that I owe it to Gerald. Kasi kung hindi talaga dahil sa kanya, hindi talaga ako ma-encourage gumawa ng BookTube. And kung hindi dahil sa readathon na ginawa niya, hindi ko makikilala yung mga friends ko ngayon. I really owe it to Gerald and this readathon. And I will keep on supporting him in this project forever and ever, I swear. So anyway, if you're interested about my PHILMYTH Readathon vlogs and TBR last year, I'm gonna put the link or the playlist on the description box. Start na natin to. Sobrang dami ko nang sinasabi. This year's PHILMYTH Readathon will start on March 28th and it will end on April 10th. And also, my badges this year. I'm so excited for that. So meron tayo itong 7 prompts and may mga lumang prompts. May mga bagong dinagdag si Gerald. Alright, so let's start with the first one. Ito, lumang prompt na to. It's called Manananggal. So alam nyo naman kung ano yung manananggal, diba? Nahati sa dalawa. So for this prompt, I have to read a book with only 2 point of view. So very specific si Moms Gerald dito. Sabi niya kasi last year, ang dami daw na nagsobra sa 2 POVs. And I'm kinda laughing kasi isa ako sa mga multiple POVs last year. Parang mga lima yata yung sa akin. I'm sorry na, okay? But right now, we are going to pick a book that has 2 POVs or perspective. And this is I'll Give You the Sun by Jandy Nelson. So this is a YA contemporary. It has 2 POVs and yun lang yung alam ko sa libro. Tingnan natin kung tungkol saan to. So the story has 2 twin brothers, Jude and Noah. Bata pa lang sila, they are like very tight, talagang hindi sila naghihiwalay. And then years later, they will not speak to one another. I'm interested. This is my manananggal. Don't call me out. It has 2 perspectives. I swear, I promise. Kahit i-search mo pa Gerald, okay? Okay, next prompt that I have is Duende. Galing din to sa dating prompt. Duende, maliit na nilalang sa Pilipinas. And sabi dito, any mass market paperback book. And to be honest, I don't have a lot of mass market paperbacks. Tapos naisip ko na Trish is actually sending me a book that is a mass market paperback. The book is My Sister the Serial Killer by, I don't know who the author is. You just have to look at the cover right now. So all I know about this book is that this one, the other sister is a serial killer or a murderer, and then the other one is a nurse. And parang ang nangyayari, pag pumapatay yung kapatid niya, yung sister niya na nurse, yun yung parang naglilinis ng crime scene. Or kung hindi man naglilinis, nagko-cover up. Hindi ko rin alam. Feeling ko lang yun. And I don't know anything about this book, to be honest. But I'm just really so interested. Because sabi dito, this is like a book that is satire. parang dark humor siya. I hope that I will receive it during the Philmyth Readathon. But I said to Trish na she doesn't really have to send it right away. So I have another option just in case hindi ko ma-receive tong book na to. The book that I'm talking about is Murder on the Orient Express by Agatha Christie. Just in case hindi dumating yung first option ko, at least meron akong second option. The next prompt is, this one was modified from last year's prompt. This is Black Lady, because sabi nga ni Gerald, let's start the colonizing everything around us. Let's stop the white culture and the white supremacy. So this time, we are doing the Black Lady. So for this prompt, you have to read a black book written by a woman of color. And this prompt was just so good. This is so genius. So I have here a book that is written by a Filipino author. Actually, I was planning to read this for a weekathon. So the book that I'm talking about is Nightfall by Eliza Victoria. So this is going to be my second book by this author. I think her main genre is science fiction, Black Mirror-esque kind of stories. So it's black, as you can see. Siguro naman, 80% na to. Diyos ko naman. So according to synopsis, there are two characters in here, Vanessa, who will find a body hundreds of floors above the ground. So, 100 floor. Meron siyang makikita doon na bangkay. And then, yung second character is si Criselda. And meron siyang modification. Bio-modification. So, parang siyang Black Mirror talaga. So, I think Vanessa and Criselda are two strangers. Dalawang characters sa isang mundo kung saan pwedeng magkita sila at pwedeng may connection sila sa isa't isa. Pero, it's not revealed in here. So, I think she really writes well in science fiction. So yeah, I'm gonna read this book for Black Lady. Okay, let's move on to the fourth prompt. Here is Maria Makiling. So in this one, you have to read a book that you think have a beautiful cover. I chose a book that I think that I can finish in one sitting because I don't want to get into a reading slump. So I chose a graphic novel that is written by a Filipino author, illustrated by a Filipino author. And I really think that this cover is gorgeous. I think it's chef's kiss. One of the most beautiful covers that I ever own. I love this cover so much. And I can't wait to read this book. And this is El Arcangel, Basbas ng Apoy by Julius Villanueva and Mervin Malonzo. So, if this is not a stunning cover, I don't know what else is. Look at that. Tingnan nyo naman, guys. Gold foil yan. Tapos yung likod ganun din. The cover is so gorgeous. It's so beautiful. I love it. So anyway, this is a graphic novel. According to synopsis ni Goodreads, sabi niya, may anino ang barangay masikap. Para makawala, kailangan nilang harapin si Ella, ang tagapagbantay sa pagitan ng dalawang mundo. Feeling ko this is fantasy. And I am just really so excited for this book. So let's move on to the next prompt, which is San Telmo. In this one, you have to read a book with fire on the cover or fire on the title. I really thought that I don't have a book for this prompt. And then I saw this and I realized, oh yeah, this is perfect. So what I have in here is a collection of short horror stories. And this is Things We Lost in the Fire by Mariana, Enriquez. So, meron pala ditong 12 na short horror stories and all of these are set in Argentina and it has like socio-political background. So, I'm just really so excited about this book because I really like stories that has, you know, reflection or commentary about what's really happening in a certain place or in a certain country. Perfect, right? Perfect. Okay, let's move on to the sixth prompt. This is called Sirena. So for this one, you have to read a book that is written in verse. To be honest, I just realized it right now. Wala pala akong masyadong books written in verse. And ito yung pinaka-nahirapan ako kasi hindi ko talaga alam ano ang babasahin ko. So dahil wala nga akong poetry books in physical format, I thought I just have to get it from ebook. So I have two books that I'm going to read for this prompt. The first book that I'm going to read is All Along You Were Blooming, Thoughts for Boundless Living by Morgan Harper Nichols. So this is a poetry book. I think this is non-fiction. It says here, a celebration of hope, an encounter with grace, a restoration of heart, a healing of wounds. An anthem of freedom, All Along You Were Blooming is the ultimate love letter from the pen of popular Instagram poet Morgan Harper Nichols to your mind, heart, soul, and body. I love this poet so much. I love her words. I follow her on Instagram and on Twitter, and I just love everything she writes. So I have here a tattoo. It says, "By grace, she'll make it." And this one was inspired by a poem by Morgan Harper and Nichols. So yeah, I'm gonna read this book. And then the second one that I am planning to read for this prompt is Pillow Talk by Alyssa Cataluna. And this one is a self-published poetry book by one of the Filipino bookish content creator, Alyssa, or Isa of Isa Not Bella. It said that it's going to be out on April 1st, and I am just so excited. I think it's very fitting for me to include it in this reading vlog. So yeah, let's do it. Final and last prompt for this read-a-thon. It's called Malakas at Maganda. So this one, you just have to read a book written in your mother tongue. So mother tongue, in my case, I'm going to read a book that is written in Tagalog. This book that I'm going to read for this prompt, this is one of my favorite series ever. The first book is included in my top 10 favorite books of 2020, and I'm gonna read the second book, and I heard ito yung pinakamaganda among all the published ones. And the book that I'm talking about is Si Jana Silang at Ang Labanang Manananggal Mambabarang by Edgar Calabria Samar. So this book, if you still don't know what this is about, this is a YA SFF series written by a Filipino author, and the writing is also in Filipino, or in Tagalog, I mean. And this follows the story of Jana Silang. And si Jana Silang, isa siyang gamer sa isang game na tinatawag na Tala. And yung Tala, it is based on Philippine mythological creatures. Para siyang Dota, pero Philippine version. So hindi ko na sa inyo babanggitin anong synopsis ng second book, kasi in case hindi nyo pa nabasa yung first book, baka ma-spoil kayo. Pero I'm so excited for this one. Grabe, binigyan ako ng goosebumps. Tinakot ako ng libro na yun. So feeling ko ganun din yung gagawin nito sa akin. So I'm gonna read it during daytime. Hindi ko siya babasahin ng gabi kasi kilala ko na yung sarili ko. Okay. Alright, so that's it, everyone. So ito yung mga books na babasahin ko para sa Philmyth Readathon. So ito yung hindi sure. Alam nyo naman akong bakit. Pero personally, I'm just really so excited for this readathon. Hindi ko rin alam kung bakit sobrang excited ko na feeling ko ako yung nagpapareadathon. Pero hindi naman talaga. Hindi ko rin maintindihan yung sarili ko, guys. Anyway, that's it, everyone. Are you also joining this readathon? If you also posted your TBR here on BookTube, I also wanna check that out. So go ahead and link it down on the comment section, or tell me what's your TBR. Do we have something similar? So whatever, let's talk down there. And yeah, that's it for this video. Thank you so much. I hope to see you on Saturday with my live book haul, and also I'm gonna give away some books. For now, goodbye. I hope that you are safe, you are healthy, you are happy, and I hope that you have registered already. Malapit na yung eleksyon, magparehistro ka na kung 18 and above ka na. Okay, and remember, the world is yours for the reading. Bye, and see you on the next one.